Assalamu alaikum dan salam sejahtera. Well, kali ini saya nak tunjukkan pada anda semua bagaimana kita nak apply a ree in our sketch. Okay? Di dalam AutoCAD, we do have three types of ree, which are rectangular ree, path ree, as well as circular ree. Ree ni, okay, command ree ni, ketika-ketika command ree ni, dia falls under home tab dan dia punya icon of the command is like this one. Kalau we expand this arrow, so you can see that this is a rectangle type of array, path array as well as polar array. So kita akan pergi satu persatu ke setiap jenis array ini dan kita tengok, ya, kita tengok bagaimana ianya boleh diaplikasikan di dalam sketches kita. Alright, I'll go to rectangle array first. Alright, let's say katakan I'm going to have a circle. Small circle here, unless I'm going to indicate the diameter. Let's say the diameter is 40 mm. Okay, enter. So I'm going to scroll it a bit. Dan saya nak buat multiple copies, okay, of this circle di sebelah x axis dan juga y axis. Okay, so let's say I'm going to pick rectangular array, right? Dan dia tanya, kalau if we refer to our command line, they will ask us select object. Which object or which lines that we're going to array? So I'm going to array this circle. So once after I selected this circle, press enter. Pak, dia akan bentuk seperti ini. Dan kita punya icon ni keseluruh command ni dia akan bertukar seperti ini, iaitu rectangular array punya command. Okay, rectangular type. So rectangular ni dia terbahagi kepada dua, iaitu baris, which is row, dan juga lajur, which is column. This is column, right? Whereas this is, all these are the rows. So we're going to focus only on both of these columns and also rows. Okay, yang levels ni semua apa, don't bother about this one, alright? So, columns, kita ada 4 column di sini, kan? 4 column, so we missed 1, 2, 3, 4. Rows ni pula 3, 1, 2, 3. So, kalau you nak tambah rows ni ke menjadi 6, you just need to select this and change it. Instead of 3, you masukkan 6. Then, you just click somewhere around here, dekat luar ni, okay? Just click anywhere. Click. Nampak dia dah 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Kalau column pun you nak buat 6 juga. So, just select this. Then change it to 6. Then just again press or click anywhere around here. Dekat luar. Just click. Click. So, dia akan tambah 6. Alright. Dan di sini kalau you perhatikan. Between untuk column ni. Between means that 120. It means that. Okay, I draw sikit. It means that the distance between this center point to this center point, jarak dia ni, okay, jarak ni adalah 120 between column. Okay, di sini ke sini 120, daripada sini ke sini, okay, daripada sini ke sini 120, daripada sini ke sini 120 and so on. Manakala untuk rows pula ni, between 120 adalah di antara titik tengah bulatan ni dan titik tengah bulatan berikutnya. So, you mean that the distance of this one is 120. Okay, sama juga dengan di sini. Distance from here to here 120. Distance from here to here 120. Even you can play around with this one. Okay, you can play around with this one. Let's say katakan I tak nak 120. I would like to make it 150. So you just change to 150. Okay, untuk column ni. So jarak dia ni nanti bukan 120 lagi dah, tetapi akan menjadi 100, 150. Okay, so once after you already key in 150, you just click anywhere outside here, kat, di bahagian sini atau anywhere. So just click. Okay, nampak dia akan bergerak. I'm going to erase this one. Alright. So, jarak sekarang antara sini ke titik tengah bulatan ni dan titik tengah bulatan ni untuk bahagian kolam dah sudah 150. Let's say untuk row pula, kalau you nak change itu to 200, just key in 200. 200, then click anywhere. Okay, click anywhere. So dia dah menjadi, dia dah jadi 200 between this center to this center. Alright. So total, what does it mean by total? Total, it means that 750 from, kalau untuk kolom, untuk bahagian kolom, the distance from here to here. Okay, maknanya keseluruhan, from here to here. So, total dia adalah 750. Okay, manakala untuk rows pula, kalau kita perhatikan untuk total ni pula, total instead from here, titik tengah bulatan ni, dan titik tengah bulatan pada hujung ni, mana keseluruhan. Keseluruhan distance adalah 1000 mm. Alright? Okay, itu adalah berkaitan dengan column and rows. Okay, sekiranya katakan kalau you just nak rows ni sebanyak 10, okay, just click sama orang ya. Dan ada 10 kita ada 10. Tapi dia punya rows ni ada 10, 1 2 3 4 5 6. Tapi column ni you nak satu saja. Kalau nak satu je, you just make one, only one. Okay, so ini satu baris. Kalau nak tiga baris, tiga baris. Okay. Begitu juga dengan sebaliknya. Let's say only row you nak satu saja. Manakala columns ni you nak 20, you just key in 20. There you are. Okay. Alright, so that is about how are you going to play around with the rectangle. So once katakan I nak buat ini 4, row dia 4. There you are. So once after confirm everything with the distance, okay, you just need to go to close array and click close array. Alright. Dia sebenarnya ini dia dah join semua, okay. So bila you click satu je mana-mana, okay, dia klik semua. Okay. So bagaimana kalau kita nak edit? Oh, I tak nak 20, I nak 10 je. So you go to here again, anywhere. Just click once. Dia akan kembali kepada rectangle array punya dialog box like this. So as what I mentioned to just now, column dia, I tak nak 20, tapi I nak 10, just make it 10, 10. Click outside here, 10. Nampak, dia dah kurang daripada 10, dan katakan I nak tambah kepada 6. 6. Right? Dan once I confirm, just click close array. There you are. Okay? So remember, untuk rectangle array ni, dia dah become one object. Alright? Become one object. Alright? Okay. That is about rectangular array. So how about if how about polar array? So polar array ni kalau kita tengok bentuk dia pun dia melibatkan circular. Okay, melibatkan circular. Let's say I'm going to have my guideline circle guideline. Let's say I'm going to make it as I on my ortho. And let's see, katakan I nak buat dia punya guidelines 1000 dia punya radius. Enter. And then, it's not necessary to have circle. Lah. You boleh buat any bentuk. Okay, any bentuk like this one. For rectangle array just now, I give you an example of circle. Okay, circle shape. Tapi you nak buat segitiga pun boleh. Or any kind of shape boleh. Okay, it's not necessary to have only circle shape only. Okay. Katakan this time, I'm going to create, katakan, polygon pula. Okay, so let's say I'm going to make it 5. Okay, enter. Then let's say center, I'm going to make it at here, quadrant. And I'm going to use inscribe. And let's say the radius, I'm going to make it 100. There you are. And then I'm going to create multiple polygon like this, in this case hexagon. Okay, di sekeliling guideline bulatan yang telah saya hasilkan ini. This is my guideline, okay. Di sekeliling atas garisan bulatan ini sebanyak 360 darjah. So, maknanya from here, pusing lengkap 360 darjah. So, I'm going to pick polar array. Then select objects. I'm going to select this. This is the object that I'm going to array. Then don't forget to press enter. Lepas tu dia tanya base point. Kalau circle array ni dia kena ada base point. So kita punya, of course kita punya center point ni lah. Pasal center point ni akan bertindak sebagai paksi untuk membolehkan dia rotate di sini. Okay. Okay, so let's say my center point is here. There you are. So sekali lagi, kali ini pola array punya dialog box pula akan terkeluar. And I don't want you to bother about this. Since kita melibatkan circle saja, so we just focus on this one only. So item dia 6. So it means that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Between ni, okay, between ni bermaksud, okay, let's say I go to here. Between 60 ni bermaksud angle di antara, okay, kepada center line ke sini. This is 60 degree. Okay. This is 60 degree. Okay. Angle between this one and next. 60. Next 60. Okay. So bermaksud angle setiap ini adalah 60, 60, 60, 60. Dan let's say katakan kalau you increase this one to, katakan I want to make it 16. Okay, then just click anywhere outside here. Okay, so dia akan, di sini pun akan berubah. Akan berubah. Okay, how about let's say I'm going to make it 270. I tak nak 360 saja, but pasal I bermula di sini. So, dia akan berakhir di sinilah 270. So, I'm going to make it 270. Then just click anywhere around here. They still maintain item 16, 270, tetapi ini telah berubah. Okay, jarak angle between this one dia telah berubah kerana dia akan, this one dia akan memenuhi untuk angle untuk 270 darjah ini. Okay, you can play around with this one. Let's say I'm going to make it this one 10. Okay, then I'm going to make it this one, let's say 180 degree. Then just click somewhere around here. Okay. Right. So, katakan kalau you nak sebelah ni, dia akan pergi sebelah ni, nanti you mirror dia je lah. Okay. You just mirror it over here. Kalau you tak nak belah sini, you nak pergi belah sana kan, you just mirror nanti. Okay. You close array and then you just mirror it. Right. Okay, now. Katakan kalau nak, bila you dah hasilkan ni, so definitely you can just erase your guideline lah. Okay, kalau let's say katakan you, oh I nak tambah lagi ataupun I buat tadi, I nak edit, so you just need to go to here and click here. Okay, click and then you can proceed with your edit. So let's say I'm going to increase this to let's say 16. Let's see how it looks like. Just click anywhere once you're okay. Okay. So dia akan makin rapat lah untuk memilih 180 darjah. Even dia punya angle between ni pun dah berubah. Kerana apa? Kerana item kita dah tambahkan daripada 10 ke 16 tadi. Okay. Right. So let's say katakan saya nombor 360 darjah. 360. And just click somewhere around here. Okay. Alright. Okay. Once after confirm, just click closer. That's all. As simple as that. Okay. Let's say katakan sebagai contoh, I nak menghasilkan satu simple gear. I create a circle here. This is my guideline. As I'm going to make again, the radius is 1000 mm. And let's say I'm going to have one teeth of the gear. So this I'm going to make it 1145. The length of this one. Or 1150. Need to make it 1150. Enter. And then I'm going to create a one more line here. So I create one more line, then enter. Then I'm going to rotate this line. Just click once only, then press enter, and I'm going to rotate it might probably around 45 degree. And that, 45 degree terlalu besar dia punya angle, so I'm going to again, I'm going to undo, then I'm going to rotate again. Might probably try out 35 degree. Okay, just nice. So once I confirm this one, I'm going to mirror this to here. I'm going to mirror this line. Enter my first point, my second point. Erase source object, no. And I'm going to trim those lines that I don't want. Then I'm going to trim. Enter, I don't want this line. I don't want this line. I don't want this line, and I don't want this line as well. So this line, pun I tak nak. Okay, I just delete this one. Now, I'm going to create some sort of like a fillet over here. So I'm going to have a fillet radius, whereby my blade radius is somewhere around, let's say 50 first. Try 50 mm. Enter. Then I'm going to pick here and 50 might be too big. I'm going to redo fillet radius. Let's say I'm going to make it 20. Then enter. Pick this line. Okay, I think it should be fine. Okay, now. Then I'm going to array by using circular array. I'm going to array only this part around this circle with 360 degrees. So I just straight away go to here and polar array. So select object, this object I'm going to array, then press enter. Then they ask us our center point. So this is our center point, and my problem, I can play around this one. Is I'm going to make it 20. Okay, dia punya jumlah, just pick somewhere here, around here also. Dia akan tunjuk seperti ini, 20. Katakan belum play around lagi, katakan how about 24. Then just click anywhere around here. Okay, I think should be fine, 20. Okay, so once confirm, okay, this one should be okay because I would like to make it 360. So kalau kita this one dia akan tetap lah kalau 360 darjah. So 15 darjah ni dia akan bergantung kepada jumlah item kita, sudut antara ini. Okay, sudut antara ini, this one. Okay, this one you remember, between ni sudut bermaksud sudut antara here to here to here and so on. Okay, sudut ni lah, sudut ni, sudut. So dia bergantung, sudut ni bergantung kepada jumlah this one dan juga pada berapa fill kita, alright, angle, fill angle kita, alright. So katakan once I confirm, I rasa confirm, okay, I just click close array. Okay, okay, once I confirm, just close it. Okay, now definitely I need to trim this one, kan? Tetapi in this particular case, kalau you go to trim and select object to trim, so you're going to select all, then enter. So bila you nak trimming, okay, you have to trim one by one like this. Okay, you have to trim it one by one like that. Okay, make sure slowly. Okay, so dia kena dilambat sikit lah, this one. Okay, kena lambat sikit lah because you would like to have this one kan, bahagian ni kan. So you kena perlahan lah buat. Alright, there you are. Okay, so again, katakan kalau you nak ubah, you just click this one once only. Okay, dan dia, you can change everything. Tetapi in this case, kita dah buat macam ni kan, kita dah trim tadi. So nanti you agak sukar lah, maknanya terpaksa buat balik circle pada tengah ni sebanyak 1000. Okay, okay, sorry, 100 pula, 1000. Okay, let's say that is 1000. Okay, lepas tu bila you nak tambah, so you kena buat balik, katakan if you want to change this one, the teeth, okay, because they involve with this one. Kalau you ubah bilangan dia ni, so ini tu pun akan berubahlah. Tapi tadi pasal kita dah trim this one, so that's why you have to create again bulatan yang beradius 1000 tadi ni, alright. Okay, let's see, I'm going to undo this, alright. So let's see, bila dah confirm ni, of course definitely kalau gear dia ada shaft pada tengah ni kan, lubang untuk shaft. So let's say I'm going to make it 300, dia punya radius. Okay, alright, so I think should be fine. Okay, should like this. Okay, again, last before we end our video. Sorry, we do have another one more, which is path array. So let's say I'm going to have circle here. This time I just create without any dimensions, and let's say I'm going to have one line here, and I'm going to have some sort like this, and I'm going to mirror both of this line. Resource object, no. So I'm going to trim. I don't want this line and this one as well. So I'm going to delete this, and then now I'm going to pull out array. I'm going to pull out array this one, and my center point is this one, and let's see, I'm going to make it 10 the items, right? Like that. 10 di dalam part, so I'm going to make it 8. Okay, just nice. Okay, so once auto confirm, just close, and then I'm going to trim those line that I don't want. I don't want this line. Okay, so you have to read on. There you are. Okay, so very straightforward. Now we go to the last type of array, which is path array. So path array ni nama pun dah path, so dia akan follow path kita. Let's say I'm going to have some sort like, let's say I off my auto, and let's say I'm going to have some sort like this one. I just simply draw and I end it over here. I just simply draw, and let's say I'm going to have one circle, and of course definitely we do have three object or three lines, so we need to make this path. This is actually the path that we're going to use for our path array. So path ni dia tak boleh ada multiple objects like this, multiple lines. Dia kena ada become one line. Kita jadikan sebagai one line. So we have to join. Remember, we already learned about join. So we need to join which object that we're going to join, all these three objects. Then press enter. There you are. And then let's say I use circle lah. Pasal circle yang paling mudah. So I just start it from here. Okay. Sama tak ada dimension, okay. I just simply create without any dimension. And then kita pergi kepada path array. Dia akan follow path ni. So select object, this object that I'm going to array, then press enter. Then they ask us path curve. Which one is our path? This is our path. Okay. Nampak? This is our path. So path ni, dia jarak saja kita boleh main. Items dengan total ni dia bergantung kepada kita punya panjang path kita ni, atau panjang curve atau panjang path ni. Okay, so that's why kita hanya boleh main jarak. Katakan jarak saya nak buat 200 saja, 200. Then once after key in 200, just press somewhere around here, just click anywhere. Okay, but dia akan rapat. Okay, so tetapi dia akan memenuhi, dia bergantung kepada panjang path yang telah kita buat ni. That's why, you know, we can change jumlah item dan juga total keseluruhan, alright? Because dia dah fix berdasarkan kepada panjang ataupun jarak path yang telah kita hasilkan. So we just only for path array, we just only can play around with the jarak antaranya, between. Okay, katalah I'm going to make it 700 jarak antaranya. So bermaksud 700 ini adalah merupakan jarak antara here to here. Okay, tukar tengah ni. Okay, so jarak antara this one to this one. Okay, so dia akan memenuhi sepanjang path kita yang tadi. Alright, so that is about the path. Okay. Okay guys, so hopefully that you understand how are we going to apply the three types of array in our sketches in AutoCAD. Okay, remember we do have three types of array, which are rectangular array, polar array, as well as path array. Thank you very much for your attention guys, and I will see you in our next coming video. Thank you very much.